Good afternoon, YouTube. Earlier today, I was working on the Ferrari, changing some parts on the exhaust. My neighbors, for some reason, had the fire truck come. Huh, fire truck. The fire department was there at their house and everything seems to be okay. I don't think anything happened. Their house didn't catch on a fire or anything, as far as I could tell. The firefighters kind of swung by the house, mentioned that I had a couple of cool cars or whatever. We joked about, you know, swapping rides for the day or something like that. I thought, you know what? We're gonna go over to the fire station that's close to my house. We'll see if one of these firefighters wants to take the Ferrari for a drive. All right, well, let's go do it. All the firefighters are on shift, can't take a ride, but I'm gonna come back one of these days and give one of these guys a ride or have one of them drive the car. So super nice guys. They even, check this out, they gave me some stickers and a patch. This is awesome. Well, anyway, let's just go for a drive then. Search is going okay. Had some interviews. The thing that's kind of complicated about my situation is CTO or VP of engineering jobs aren't like super common, so it's gonna take me a little while if I'm sticking out trying to get one of those jobs versus I could go just get a developer's position pretty much this week, but I'd be taking a huge cut in salary. And actually, I've applied to a bunch of developer positions and I've already been rejected by a bunch of them because they said I'm overqualified. So I get that, it's fine. They don't want to hire someone who's just gonna bail after a few months. That's the reality, you know. If I ended up with a developer position, it's very likely it would be the case. So I'd just be buying time until I could find a CTO or VP of engineering position. So in the meantime, I'm trying to find possibly like a consulting or a contract position. I have a friend who is like a serial entrepreneur. We've been talking, something might happen with that. Actually, one of my viewers, one of you guys, reached out to me and has a company and is interested in possibly having me do some consulting slash contract work. So that's also something I'm highly interested in. My thought is, I don't want to... I don't want to take just the first thing that comes because then I'm gonna get bored. I wanna find something where I really enjoy the job, that I'm happy. I also potentially need a job that allows some flexibility, that allows me to possibly go take care of the rental cars in the middle of the day. Remote work is really appealing because here's the reality is when I worked from home, I wasn't working 40 hours a week. I was working way more than that because there was always something going on. I would work until I was done. Basically, it wasn't like, oh, it's 5 o'clock, I'm done for the day. No, it's more like, I'm not done with this task yet, I'm gonna keep going. Sometimes I'd be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 o'clock at night, whatever. That's kind of always been my philosophy, is just, you know, work until you get to a good stopping point. Don't work until you hit the end of time for the day. So I hate stopping mid-thought. Unless there's sometimes you need to just walk away and clear your brain, right? That's also something that you need to do sometimes. Oh, such a beautiful day. Friday, you need to stretch your legs. Eventually I'll find something. It might take 1, 2, 3 months is my guess. You know, fortunately, Meg and I will be okay in that amount of time. We'd be okay for quite a few months, but you know, I would like to get some income going as fast as possible, just because I don't want to totally ruin all of our savings. You know, it would be nice to have some of our savings left after this whole thing. But I really gotta take a moment and just, honest to God, I have to thank all of you for the positive comments, the amazing things that you guys have said. The amount of support I've received has just been almost overwhelming. The first few days after I published the video of getting laid off, I almost had a hard time just keeping up with the comments, with the number of people who called me or texted me or sent me DMs or whatever. It was amazing, and it shows how many good people are still out there. It makes me feel appreciated, like, okay, I'm not just doing this YouTube stuff in vain. Really, you guys actually do care, which makes me feel like, wow, what an amazing thing that's happened. All the support from people who have never met me. It was truly heartwarming, and thank you so much. And Meg and I both really appreciate it. She was blown away too. I can't thank you enough. Truly, it's been a touching experience. In the world of YouTube, some updates are, I'm working on 2 sponsorship deals. One is fairly close to being solid. Oh, that's just a fun part right here. One of the deals is almost solidified. Another one's gonna take a little while, but my whole thing with sponsorships, Ben, I don't want to just make shill posts. I don't want to like promote some product that has no reason to be promoted on my channel other than to make me money. So I'm not going to promote some random product that I don't use or don't believe in, or some company that I don't like or whatever. I'm only going to promote stuff that I think is relevant to the channel, relevant to you guys, something that I feel is, you know, a worthy thing, or something I would buy myself or have bought. So for example, the Blackview camera, I bought multiple Blackview cameras before I got them to sponsor me. And I only reached out to them because I thought their cameras were so damn good. I'll keep you in the loop on that. I'll make sure never to let you guys down and promote some bullshit. I'll keep it real. Particular things that you guys would want to see worked on in this car? I know a lot of you have said, hey, are you going to replace the clutch on it myself? I'm actually genuinely considering it. I have to do a little more research to make sure I actually can do it. The trick to that would be, obviously, I can't reprogram the computer myself, so even if I change the clutch, I would have to get the car put onto a flatbed and towed to somewhere that could reprogram the computer, or have them bring the computer out to the car. Is there any particular maintenance that you think needs to happen or whatever? Maybe if you're a 430 owner and you've got something that you want done on your car, I could do it and show you how to do it. I know some of the things that have been brought up are some of the ball joints on these cars are known to go bad. The design was just not right. The window switches, the buttons in the car get sticky, so replacing those. Tie rod ends, door latch, the cable stretches on this car and it's a pain in the ass. So that's something to consider. Oh, I love this car. It's exactly the kind of day where you just want to own a car like this. Kind of weird, because it's not my personality to not work, and to be in the middle of the day out farting around in my car, I mean, let's be real, it's pretty glorious, it's pretty amazing. One thing that's kind of tricky about this car is the speedo goes up to 220, so the difference between 20 and 25 is like sneezing. Very difficult to keep it within 5 miles an hour, especially at the lower RPMs, because it takes so little effort on the pedal to make such a dramatic effort in speed. Oh. big question that keeps coming up is people keep saying I need to work for myself. I completely agree. The problem is I don't have something totally lined up yet, so I may have to take one or two more jobs in my career before I can kind of become my own boss. Unfortunately, the YouTube stuff's just not quite there yet. This car.